Dear children, hope you all have seen both the videos. And after watching those videos, I told you to read lesson 5, the Southern Plateaus and the Islands. And also I told you to try and solve the book work by yourself. Hope you have tried it. Now children, let us check the work you have done is correct or not. So, take out your book, page number 37. Let us start with Get Set. The first one here, tick the correct answers. Which of the following statements about plateaus is incorrect? It is a flat topped land with steep sides. This is correct. Glaciers are found in the plateaus. This is incorrect. So you have to tick the incorrect one. So you tick this. Glaciers are not found in the plateaus. See, the Deccan Plateau is in the southern part of India. Yes, this is correct. So among these three, you have to tick only the incorrect one. Okay. Now come to the second question. Which of the following statements about islands is correct? A. Water surrounded by land is called an island. Water surrounded by land is called island. No, this is wrong. There are three main groups of island in India. Is this correct? No, there are only two groups of island. We have studied in the map also, we have seen that there are two group of islands, and these two groups of islands are Andaman and Nicobar Island and Lakshadweep Island. Correct? So there are only two groups of island, and that's why this statement is also wrong. And see this next one. Lakshadweep Island are in the Arabian Sea. Yes, in the map, when you will see the map like this, here is Andaman and Nicobar Island, and here it is Lakshadweep Island, and here it is Bay of Bengal, and here Arabian Sea. So it is written Lakshadweep Island are in the Arabian Sea. Yes, this is correct. And here in this second question, you have to tick the correct one. Clear? Now let us see the next page. Here, checkpoint, page number 40. Page number 40. Here, see the checkpoint. Here you can see this river divides the southern plateaus into two parts. Can you name that river? Yes, it is Narmada. Narmada River. Now next, this is the longest river in the Deccan Plateau. Can you name the longest river in Deccan Plateau? Yes, it is Godavari. Godavari. Clear? Now third one. This place in Madhya Pradesh has diamond mines. Yes, it is Panna. P-A-N-N-A. P-A-N-N-A. Panna. See the fourth one. This state is famous for Bidri work. Which state is famous? Here you can see Bidri work, and it is famous in Telangana. So right here, Telangana. T-E-L-A-N-G-A-N-A. Telangana. Now, take out page number 42. Here, read and answer. Clear? First, fill in the blanks. The Jog Falls is in the state of, yes, Karnataka. K-A-R-N-A-T-A-K-A, Karnataka. I will give you the PDF of this. Just you listen and try to answer. Second one, the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats meet at the Nilgiri Hills. Clear? Now third, the Bandhavgarh National Park is a major tourist attraction in Madhya Pradesh. Clear? Now see the fourth one. Dash is the most popular festival of Maharashtra. Can you name the festival? Yes, it is Ganesh Chaturthi. Ganesh Chaturthi. Now next, the fifth one. The cellular jail is in Andaman and Nicobar Island. I will give you the PDF of it. In that, I will write the full word of Andaman and Nicobar. Just you listen now. B part, write T for true and F for false. First one, the Chota Nagpur Plateau lies in the central highlands. Is it correct? Yes. True. Upside of the North Narmada River, we see Chota Nagpur Plateau to the eastern side. Clear? Now second one, Anaimudi is the highest peak in the Deccan Plateau. Is this correct? Yes, it is true. Next, Bhilai is famous for tin mining. Is Bhilai famous for tin mining? Yes, it is false. No. Tin mining is not there in Bhilai. Now the next one, Kannad is the main spoken language in Karnataka. Yes, it is true. Come to the next one, Lakshadweep Islands. Now fifth, Lakshadweep lies in the Bay of Bengal. Is Lakshadweep lies in the Bay of Bengal? No, Andaman and Nicobar lies in the Bay of Bengal. Just now we have studied, na? So, it is false. Right here, false. This one is false. Clear? Lakshadweep lies in the Bay of Bengal is false because Andaman and Nicobar lies in Bay of Bengal. Clear? Now, come to the next page. Here in this page, these question answers I have already given to you. And now come to the activity. Clear? Do and learn activity. Here, first one is activity. Write the names of the states where the following are situated. This you can see on the map also. Also, you can find out through Google. Clear? I don't know whether you have found out it or not. I will tell you the answer. The first one, Chitrakoot Falls. It is in Chhattisgarh. Chhattisgarh. Clear? Now next, second one, Betla National Park. Betla National Park is in Jharkhand. Jharkhand. Now next, third one, Gateway of India. Where it is? It is in Maharashtra. Here you have to write the name of the states. Clear? So it is in Maharashtra. Now come to the next one, fourth one. Golconda Fort. This you have studied in the lesson. It is there in Telangana. Telangana. Then Sachi Stupa. Sachi Stupa is in Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh. And next one, Gol Gumbaz. Gol Gumbaz is in Karnataka. Clear, children? Now, this is all about the book work of this lesson. Yes, children, this map work, mark and label the following on the map of India given on page number 134. This I have already given in activity. And after completing this chapter, let us proceed to my page. Next, turn the page. Here my page is given. And in this page, children, the questions from lesson number 1 to 5 is given. Let us solve this page. Here activity. These cities were named differently in the past. Use the internet to find out their old names. Clear? Some of you are already knowing. Kolkata. Kolkata is in the past it was Calcutta. 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 Clear? Second is Chennai. And how this cities were named? This city was named in the past. It was Madras, Chennai. Madras, M-A-D-R-A-S. We used to say Madras to this city. Now it is changed in Chennai. Third one is now called Mumbai, but earlier we call it Bombay. Bombay. Clear? Here Varanasi is given. Nowadays we are saying Varanasi, but previously it was said Banaras. Banaras. Clear? And fifth, Bengaluru. And earlier it was called Bangalore. B-A-N-G-A-L-O-R-E. Panaji. Panaji. It was called Panjim. Sorry. P-A-N-J-I-M. Panjim. Here. Next one. Kochi. Earlier it was called C-O-C-H-I-N. Cochin. Clear? And Vadodara. Now it is called as Vadodara. And earlier it was called by Baroda. B-A-R-O-D-A. We call it Baroda. The next question is given here. Look at the pictures and write the names of these occupations. Choose from the box. Tell your partner the names of the states where these occupations are popular. Clear? See the occupation. In the first picture, it is shown that the lady is collecting the tendu leaves. These tendu leaves which are used to make bidis. So, this tendu leaves, you have to write what she is doing. Right, collecting tendu leaves, and it is the occupation of Chhattisgarh. Clear? I will give you the, I will provide the PDF of the same, okay? Now see the second one. What you can see in this picture? Yes. Let us see the second one. Here. Second one. Number two. What you see in this picture? Yes, the fishing. This picture is of fishing. And where this fishing is done? In the coastal areas. So can you name the coastal areas? Yes. Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh. Then Odisha is also the coastal area. Then West Bengal, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and Lakshadweep. All these coastal areas, fishing is done. People's occupation is fishing. Clear? Now next, here what you can see in this third picture? In the third picture, you can see that here wood carving, they are doing the wood carving. Clear? And wood carving is done in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, and Nagaland. Clear? Now come to the fourth picture. The fourth picture, it is shown that coir rope making. Clear? And coir rope making is done in Kerala and Lakshadweep, where coconuts are found in abundance, a lot. Clear? Now children, come to the next page. Here in the next page, map work is given here. And read the clues, then mark and label the states and union territories on the given map of India. Here the map of India is given. So let us see with the help of clues. First, this state is famous for Tawang Monastery. Yes, it is Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh. Clear? Come to the second one. Malayalam is spoken in this group of islands. Yes, can you tell me? Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep. Clear? Now third one. Tourists visit the Golden Temple in this state. Where? Tell me the name of the state. Punjab. Punjab. Clear? This, now fourth one. This state is famous for Kolar gold mines. Yes, just now you have studied. It is Karnataka. Clear? Karnataka. Next one. Come to the fifth point. The Thar Desert is in this state. Where? Where is the Thar Desert? In Rajasthan. Rajasthan. Next. Saffron is cultivated here. Where saffron is cultivated? Jammu and Kashmir. Clear? So come to the seventh point. People of this state are fond of zakuti, a type of dish. Yes, Goa. Now next, Sela is a popular dance of this state. Yes, it is Chhattisgarh. Chhattisgarh. Now you can easily locate these states on this map. Clear, children? This is all about book work. And children, hope you have understood this lesson very well, lesson up to lesson 5. And prepare lesson 5, the Southern Plateaus and the Islands, for class test on 13 August. Clear, children? Now have a nice day.